Hello everyone, welcome. In today's video, I want to talk to you about the high resistance versus the high accuracy. Which one is easy to reach and which one is the better, I guess, right? So let's start with the accuracy. So for the accuracy, guys, you have lots of the alternative reaching the high accuracy. First of all, let's talk about the speed team first of all. So accuracy user is the speed team, right? So they have one speed leader like Arbiter or the Lissandra or the Spee, doesn't really matter. They don't need accuracy, they just need speed. And then they need a second booster, maybe. But most of the time they don't need it. They need a champion like Madame Ceres. She's broken, by the way, I have to tell it, but the basic, she have a basically two champion skill at the same skill, guys. This skill is too strong. She's an epic champion and this skill is too strong. And even this A2 actually pretty annoying as well. So basically, whenever she use this skill, you are dead. I mean, I have a resist team, guys. Maybe let me show you my main team right now. This is my main team, guys. This team can be lost against the Madame Ceres, guys. Yeah, it's not fair if you ask me. It's not fair. Look, I will be okay if they using the Setelia plus decrease defense champion. Because instead of one champion, if there is a no Madame Ceres in the game, they has to be forced to use two champion, guys, instead of the only one champion. Yeah. Anyway, speed team, they need a speed booster. No accuracy needed. They need a cleanse, I mean remove buffer slash decrease defense champion like the Madame Ceres. She basically same champion, so she need a decent speed, enough speed to reach the Arbiter. She need a accuracy, that's it. Nothing else, guys. Good thing about the speed team, rest of your champion don't need accuracy. Your speed booster don't need accuracy if it is not Lissandra, obviously. Your debuffer need accuracy, but your DPS champion don't need accuracy. But on the resist team, every champion kinda need a resistance, right? For example, you just can't make your Duchess high resistance and or the sweep reset and dream like you are gonna win the battle because she's gonna revive, right? Let's say she revived, guys, okay? Let's say she revived the enemy, all of your teammates. She managed to survive. She revived. What next? Again, they have a double speed booster, right? Usually, because they have using the Madame Ceres, they have a space, one more space. They just need one speed booster, Madame Ceres, and the DPS champion. Or if they have or they can use a champion like me, for example, Sylar. And Madame Ceres, instead of they are making the fast of them, they can use the Sylar. But right now they don't need it. And because of they are fast, guys, they can take a turn, take a turn, take a turn, and they can keep killing your revived teams, actually. They can actually kill you, guys. It's not a solution. So rest of your team has to be high resistance as well. It is a one bad part on the resist side. Is there any good side on the resist side? Actually, my team can work if the enemy team don't have a Madame Ceres. They can work very well. Not gonna lie. Let's say they are using the Setelia, they are using, or they are using the Kaimar. Kaimar can be a problem a bit because he's resetting the skill. But other than that, Setelia is not that a big problem actually, guys. Or is there any more remove buffer? I actually don't remember. But against the Madame Ceres, because the Madame Ceres also plays in a decrease defense, it's hurting a lot, guys. Especially if you are facing against the Tyrande fully, they definitely can nuke. Let me show you my stat on the Duchess, by the way. 53k HP, 4.6k defense, 250 speed, and 622 resistance. I'm using my Lydia aura, so which give me 100 more resistance, which means Shiva 722. This is nothing else. 700 resistance. Right now we have a bot page on the arena. So, but if you guys remember the arena before the bot, I'm talking about the high gold. It's not enough for the high gold, and yeah, it's not even enough for the platinum tier. No. Because this let's go to the juicy part, guys. So making a resistance high resistance versus a high accuracy actually different. Actually, it's way more easier to reach the high accuracy than the resistance, because let me show you one thing. For example, let's check the masteries first of all. Plus 10 resistance here, plus 50 resistance here, so we have a 60, right? I'm not counting this skill, guys, because this skill is only working if you are going first. For example, if you are facing against the speed team, and if they have a Madame Celeste, you know, they are gonna use their skill first before your Duchess, right? Your Duchess has to cast buff to get this resist from them. So I'm not counting them. As I know, guys, I may be wrong, but each debuff on this champion. This is not a solution either. I mean, we are trying to get a not debuff, right? We are trying to get not debuff. Yeah, we only getting 60 resistance from the defense tree. But let's check to the support tree. 10 here, same, exactly same. And 50 here, exactly same. So we have a 60 so far, but 20 here, so we have 80, and 16 here, so we have 96. 60 versus 96. See that? 60 versus 96. So far, accuracy is one step ahead from the masters. Let's go the other part. Set item. So only the get high resistance, guys. You guys need a resistance set from the ice column. There is no other way to get this set in the game. The only way you can get it is from the ice column. As you guys see, I still have a two piece of resistance set on my Duchess. And let me show you my gear on the resistance, guys. I mean, I'm not farming the ice golem that often because it's terrible place for the farming. But recently they did a 2x for the resistance on the ice golem, if you guys remember that. I farmed there like a crazy on the 3 days. But end of the day, I got nothing. This is the total resist piece I have. Okay? On the accuracy, what set can accuracy have? Let's check it. For example, let me check my Madame series. So as you guys see here, it is the same rule. They can also farm the accuracy chest, accuracy gear from the dragon, right? But there is one big difference. Yeah. They can also craft the perception set, which is give 40 accuracy and 5% speed on the two piece of gear at the forge. If you guys see the forge here, perception, easy to craft, easy to get. Crafting a gear from the forge is way more better than the dungeons, guys. There is always high chance of getting better gear compared to the dungeons, because we can use the forge to increase the ore luck, right? But if you guys check the forge again, rest of the gear from here. Are you guys seeing any resistance? Yes, there is one resistance over there. Untouchable. Immunity plus 40 resistance. Looking good, right? Yeah, looking good. But this is a 4 set, guys. This is a 4 set. This is not 2 set. Lyrium. I have no idea what are you thinking but make it a forge gear versus 2 piece plus 40 accuracy versus 4 piece plus 40 resistance, it's not fair. This is not fair. Like I said guys, this is my main team. Let me show you one more time. This section of my main team. I ended using my accuracy team on the attack team arena. Actually recently reworked them. But let me show you how many perception set I have. Let me show you my resistance one more time. Just to be clear. This is my resist piece guys. Okay. And this is my perception guys. See the difference? I still have 166. I mean, I still can craft 166 more at my forge. I still can do that. This is actually makes really difference, guys, because you guys saw my Duchess resist, right? Let me show you one more time. 622. And let me show you my Madame series. Hold on, hold on. There we go. 700. 700, and let me show you the her glyph on the gear. 6, 7, 5, 6, 7, 7. So they are the 6 star gear. So which means you can get, you can upgrade them to the 16. I can easily reach the 750 accuracy with no problem, guys. Not any single problem. Not any single problem, actually. Same with my Sylar. Look, her gears are not maximum either. I mean, I'm talking about the glyph and the stuff. But let's check her. 645, man. I didn't even push myself to make them, actually, guys. You guys can check my votes maybe if you guys find it, but I just make them really easily. I didn't it was really easy for me to make reach the high accuracy, guys. It is really easy. Okay, there is one more thing. There is a reaction set, yes. I have to say it, they are really actually broken. They actually really good for the go second team, like a resist team, something like that. Like, they can be trouble for your speed team, guys. I'm talking about Madame series or the, you know, accuracy team. But it's hard to reach them, right? I mean, guys, we still don't have, I mean, I still don't have any reaction set, if I remember correctly. Let me check one more time. On the Demon Spawn, for example. See that? I don't have any on the Demon Spawn. So getting a gear from the clan versus clan is already hard. And getting a right gear for your champion is also hard. You have to get a right gear. You have to get a gear from the clan versus clan. And it has to be also in the good sub state and good main state, something like that. So it is hard to reach that, okay? Not everyone can do it. But it's not hard to reach Madame series, right? He's an epic champion, for example. And there is also one more thing, guys. Game also releasing champions like, for example, Yoshi. Let's check this skill. He's a custom increased accuracy, guys. For example, if you have a trouble to reach in high accuracy, just use the Yoshi, right? Problem solved. But do you guys know any increased resistance buff? As I know, there is no. But even we get one, even we get champion like that, increased resistance, it's still not gonna be work, guys. We needed something, I don't know. We needed something unique there, because resist teams are not going first anyway, right? They are always going second or the third or something like that, depends of your speed. But they are definitely not going first against the spin against the split team. Or we need a champion that can counter the Madam series. Like Epic Champion would be fair. But right now Akira is always one step ahead, guys. Always. Game is always keeping the split meta for a while. I don't know how to make the resist team decent, actually. Fair fight. I'm talking about the fair fight here. I'm not counting the reaction set yet because it's hard to reach them, guys. Not everyone can reach that like a Madam series. I mean, getting a Madam series also hard, I'm not gonna lie. But it's still possible, right? It's an epic champion, right? Oh, also one more note, guys. Wait, did I say that at the beginning of the video? I think I did, but let me tell it again. Again, your rest of the resist team, rest of your champion also need to be high resistance, kind of. Otherwise, they are gonna die. They are gonna get CC, debuff, stuff like that. And yeah, there is also, okay, I just remember one more thing. So in this game, we also have CC gear. Like Daze, like Stun, okay, like Taunting, something like that, guys. I don't think we have a, I think we have a free set either. Yeah, free set either. So about this set, guys, you don't need accuracy and enemy resistance, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. This set items, there is a little percent, it's actually not that bad. For example, stun 18%, but you can increase it like from the masteries. Like, let me check it, which one is that? This one. Yep, this one over there, 5%. So 18 plus 5, 23%. For example, stun 23, but if you guys check the taunt gear, for example, it's a 30%, so 35%. Doesn't matter your resistance, guys. They can if this is a proc, they are gonna land. Also, one more thing. Again, one more thing. I just remember one more thing. It's never ending, right? We have champions like unique champions like Ghostburn, for example. If you check his A3, guys, he's casting decreased defense and this skill cannot be resisted. Which means you don't even need a single accuracy on him. This skill always gonna be land if this is not, it is not weak attack. Okay? We also have one more champion. I don't know if we have more than these two, probably. I don't really remember right now, but if you guys check the Suzerain A3. Remove shield, block damage, unkillable buff from the all enemies, okay? Then attack them. This buff removal cannot be blocked or the resisted. So we also have a champion like that, guys. But do you guys know any champion can give us protection? I'm talking about resisting. They give us a protection against the accuracy. Do you guys know anything like that? I only know one champion. It's a new champion and it's a legendary champion. It's a Brogni. His shield is cannot be removed, which is good. But funny thing is, he has to cast this skill, right? So he has to go first. I mean, he has to go before the enemy Madam series. To do that, you need a speed booster, right? So I feel like, yeah, this is not useful right now. Let's be honest each other. This is not counter the Madam series. And why we are, I mean, obviously it is not gonna be fair. Let's say he's a counter for the Madam series. It's still not gonna be fair because Madam series is epic champion. So yeah. And I hope you guys can get an idea, some idea how easy to reach the high accuracy versus the resistance. So Accuracy is way more easier, guys. Way more easier because of the perception gear, actually. And also, okay, let's remove the perception set. Okay, let's remove the perception set. Let's go to dungeons, guys. Where you can farm the accuracy? It's a dragon, right? Dragon also dropped in the speed, right? Which is, you actually need these two for the speed team. You actually need these two. But if we check the ice golem, we don't need anything else than the resistance here. What we need also, we also need the shield set, right? But shield set inside the fire knight, guys. There we go. So yeah, it's not fair. Right now game needs some changes there. Right now it's not fair, guys. Anyway, thanks for watching me, guys, and I hope you guys like it. I hope you guys have any idea, and I see you guys on the next video. Take care, guys, everyone, and have a nice day. Bye bye, guys.